Hello students, in this class we can study about the next 18th group elements. 18th group elements, that 18th group elements also called as the noble gases. This is very most important. To get centum in chemistry subject, that is 100 out of 100, you have to concentrate this noble gas chapter, because in your board exam in the first main they can take one question from the noble gases. This entire noble gas chapter carries weightage only one mark. You have to concentrate on each and every word. Even for competitive, they can take one question from the 18th group elements. Then these 18th group elements means helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon. Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon, these are called as the 18th group elements. 18th group of elements. These 18th group elements, they mainly present in air. They occur in the air. They mainly present in air. Hence, these elements we called as the aerogens. Aerogens. There are different names for the 18th group element. One of the name is the aerogen. Why they are called aerogens means because they mainly present in the air, atmospheric air. Hence, they are called as the aerogens. They mainly present in atmospheric air. Hence they are called aerogens. That atmospheric air contains 1% by volume. Atmospheric air contains only 1% by volume. That is, due to their low abundance, the occurrence in the atmosphere is very, very low. Due to their low abundance in the atmosphere, they are also called as the rare gases. Rare gases. That 18th group elements also called rare gases because in the atmospheric air, their occurrence is very low. That is 1% by volume of the atmosphere contains only these aerogens. And due to their low abundance, they are called the rare gases. Then, 18th group elements complete its octet configuration, octet structure. Octet configuration means NS2NP6. This is the octet configuration, octet structure. They are chemically, due to completion of the octet configuration, they are chemically inert, inactive. They not combines with the other element. They are chemically inert in nature. Why they are chemically inert in nature? Means due to their stable octet configuration. They already complete its octet structure. They not combines with any other element. They are chemically inert in nature. Hence, they are called as the inert gases. Inert gases. 18th group element also called as an inert gases or noble gases. Noble gases. Then, very most important one is argon is the most abundant. They can ask for one mark. Name the most abundant rare gas, inert gas. The most abundant rare gas is the argon. And xenon. Xenon is the least abundant rare gas. Least abundant rare gas is the xenon. And most abundant rare gas is the argon. The rare gas not present in the air, atmospheric air, the rare gas, the noble gas, which not present in the atmospheric air, is the radon. Radon is the rare gas which not present in the atmospheric air. Why radon not present in atmospheric air mean? Because radon is an radioactive rare gas. They can ask for one mark. Name the radioactive inert gas. The radioactive rare gas is the radon, which not present in the atmospheric air. That radon is obtained by the decay product, that is by the decomposition, by the decay of the radium. That radium decomposes to give the radon and helium. That radium atomic number 88 and mass number is of 226. Then radon atomic number is of 86 and mass number of 222, and helium atomic number 2, mass number 4. This is the decomposition of the radium. By the decomposition of radium, we get the radon. Radon is radioactive rare gas. Then helium and neon also present in the minerals. That minerals like the pitch blende. That also present in the minerals. Helium and neon present in the minerals like pitch blende, monazite, or maybe of the clavite. In the minerals like pitch blende, monazite and clavite, they mainly contain the helium and the neon. Then very most important one for one mark is natural gas is the main commercial. It is the main commercial source of helium. They can ask, name the commercial source of the helium. The commercial source of the helium is the natural gas. Natural gas is the main commercial source of the helium. That helium also present in the solar system. The solar system also contains the helium. This is about the occurrence of the noble gases. You have to concentrate on the occurrence, because from the occurrence they can take one more question. This is about the occurrence. Next, you can study about the properties, general properties. You note down this one and practice for one mark. Then you study the general properties. Then, among the general properties, first one is the electronic configuration. The general electronic configuration of the noble gases is NS2NP6, that is the stable octet configuration. This is the NS2NP6. General configuration of the noble gases is NS2NP6, except helium. Helium is 1s2 configuration. 1s2, this is called duplet configuration, while NS2NP6 is called as an octet configuration. All the noble gases have the general configuration of NS2NP6 except that of the helium. Helium configuration is 1s2. It is commonly called as the duplet. They can ask for one mark. Name the noble gas which does not contains p electrons. That is, helium has only 1s2, it has duplet configuration. Helium not contains the p6 configuration, it has only 1s2. Due to the general chemical inertness only, that helium is studied under the noble gases. This is very most important one. Even in 2 years back, that is nearly 2018 paper, they can ask this question for the one mark. Name the noble gas which not contains the np6 electron, that is of helium. Then second general property is the atomic and the ionic size. Atomic and ionic size or radius. Atomic size increases down the group, that is from helium to neon, sorry, xenon, helium to xenon. Atomic size increases because that screening effect increases because electron centered with the new shells. Hence atomic and ionic size increases from helium to xenon. The third one is ionization enthalpy, also called potential, ionization potential. These noble gases, they have very high ionization enthalpy. Noble gases have very high ionization enthalpy. Why they have very high ionization enthalpy means due to their stable octet configuration. Octet configuration means NS2NP6. Due to their stable octet configuration, they have very high ionization enthalpy. That ionization enthalpy decreases from helium to xenon. That is down the group, ionization enthalpy decreases. Then next property is electron gain enthalpy. These 18th group elements, they shows the zero electron gain enthalpy. They show zero electron gain enthalpy, or they shows the positive value. Why they show zero electron gain enthalpy means the they have no tendency to accept the electron. Why they have no tendency to accept the electron means because they already complete their octet structure, they already complete its octet configuration. Hence they have no tendency to accept the electron. Based on that one, that is 18th group element, they shows the zero electron gain enthalpy. This is about the general properties. Next you study the physical properties. Among the physical properties, all the noble gases, they becoming monoatomic. That is, you can write only He, not He2. It is monoatomic, or neon, NE, or maybe argon, AR only, not AR twice, or maybe krypton, KR, or XE. They are being monoatomic. Why they are monoatomic in nature means, again, due to their stable octet configuration. Already in chemical bonding we studied why do atoms combines mean to attain their stable octet configuration. Either they can lose the electron or they can gain the electron. But already noble gases have stable octet configuration, hence they do not combine with each other. Hence they are monoatomic in nature, they are colorless and tasteless gases. Then they are sparingly soluble in water. Then very most important one, they have very low melting and boiling point. This is very most important for one mark. Why they are low melting and boiling point mean? Because they are monoatomic in nature. And have no interatomic forces. They have no interatomic forces. Except weak dispersion forces. Only between that atoms there is a weak dispersion forces. Being they are monoatomic, they have no interatomic forces except that of weak dispersion forces. Hence they show no melting and the boiling point. This reason is very very important one. Then they can be liquefied. They can be liquefied due to the absence of the interatomic forces. They can be liquefied at very low temperature. They can be liquefied at low temperature. That ease of liquefaction, this is important for competitive. Ease of liquefaction increases with increase in the size. Ease of liquefaction increases with increase in the size. That is, liquefaction order is helium less than neon less than argon less than krypton less than xenon. Among the noble gases, xenon can be easily liquefiable gases. Then noble gases, they are very less reactive in nature. They are very less reactive in nature. Noble gases are very less reactive in nature. The chemical inertness, that is less reactive nature, is mainly due to the one reason is stable octet configuration. Stable octet configuration, that is NS2, NP6 configuration. Then second reason is high ionization enthalpy, and one more is high positive electron gain enthalpy. Hence they are less reactive or chemically inert in nature. The chemical inertness is due to stable octet configuration, high ionization enthalpy and high positive electron gain enthalpy. In the next class, you can study about the chemical properties. Note down this one. Very, very important for the one mark. Each and every reason is important. You can take any reason, any type of the reason. You have to concentrate for in all the reasons. In the next class, you can study about the chemical properties.